Hi, I'm George, and I'll be showing you how to change sounds inside of Minecraft Bedrock. And we'll use that barrel back there, the barrel opening sound, as our test sound. I'm going to switch around and I'll show you how that sounds normally. Okay, here's the regular Minecraft barrel sound. And I'll now change the resource pack and show you the sound we'll be using. Okay, and here's the barrel open sound with our new sound. All right, let's get to it. To change sounds in Minecraft, we'll need to have a new sound or sounds, and we'll also need to have a new resource pack to put those sounds into, and then install that resource pack into Minecraft Bedrock. Okay, I'll switch out of Bedrock here, and I'll show you how all that's done. Okay, we're here on my desktop, and the first thing you'll need is a folder to put things in. I have one I set up right here called Sounds. You can call it anything you want, put it in any place you want on your computer. Just make sure you have a separate folder for doing this. Inside of here, I have a downloaded brand new resource pack. I'll show you where to get this in just a bit. I also have my sound right here. It's a metal clang sound in a WAV file format. And if you want, you can have a custom pack icon PNG file. This is just a 256 by 256 PNG file. Image can be anything you want. And this just replaces the default one that comes with the standard resource pack. Let's take a look at that real fast. I'll go inside here. And there is the default pack. Let me just change the view here and we'll see what that looks like in a nice thumbnail view. There it is. Pretty boring. So I'm just replacing that with my own image right there. But that's all that is. Okay, the first thing we need to do is to convert the sound file into the .ogg or .ogg format. And for that, I use a program over here called Audacity. The reason I like this is that it's free. It does everything you need, and it's a free program. Let's take a fast look right now and show you where this is. And here we go. It's at audacityteam.org. And again, it's a free download. Okay, so that takes care of where you can find that. Any audio editor will work. It just has to be able to convert to the .ogg format. If you have something else, just see what it will export or convert to. And if it does that, then you're fine. If you don't have one of those, then the Audacity is a free program. And let's open the file. File open. And there it is right there. Of course, you may need to navigate to your file location up here, but I have mine right there. Choose open. This one happens to be a mono sound, and mono sounds work best for these little quick sounds that are inside of Minecraft. So I recommend if you have a stereo sound, just convert that to mono to make sure that everything runs as cleanly as possible. And then we'll now export this, file, and come down to export, export as OGG or OGG. There's my folder. Now you may need to navigate to the right location over here, just, you know, down click any of these options over there. But there's a folder I'll be saving this into. Make sure that it's being saved as the OGG format, and it says .ogg right here, and choose save. Choose OK. Let's just double check, make sure it's showing up. And there it is. And that's all we need to do with that sound file. That's done. Now you can't just rename this. Your sound file has to be exported or converted to the .ogg format. Okay, that's the first part of this. That's all taken care of. We have our sound. The next thing we need is to get a nice brand new copy of the resource pack, and you can download that online from minecraft.net. Let me bring up that browser window. Here it is, and you'll find this at minecraft.net. Mine is English US. If yours is a different language, you may see a different notation right there, and it's the add-ons. Now, all of these links I'm showing you, I'll have all of these up on my website, so you can go ahead and click over to my website and get those download links. You don't have to copy them off down here. So we're on this add-ons page. So scroll down. It's a little ways down here. There's some videos and stuff in here. And what you'll want to do is come down to this section. It's down below these two download buttons here. Ignore those. And it's above the installation instructions. Ignore that. What you want is this link right here. That's the one you want that says resource packs. So click on that. This will then open up a download window. Again, you may have to navigate to your correct folder that you're saving this in, and then to save it in this location and choose save. Okay, that takes care of that. We now have our resource pack. One more thing you'll need in just a little bit is one more site over here, and this is UUIDGenerator.net. Again, I'll talk about this in just a little bit. Again, I have this link and all of the links available on my website. Okay, let's go back here to our folder. So we have our resource pack right there. I just unzipped this already, and that's what I have right there. That's all that is. Now inside of here, let's open this up. Bunch of files. There's this pack underscore icon png file right here. Let's fix that first. And that's just taking my pack icon png here, my customized one. I'm just going to drag this over there and replace that file. Okay, that's taken care of. So now it has my pack in here. That's fine. There's also a file here called manifest.json, and we need to edit this file right here, and that's what that UUID generator tool is back there. Now I have mine set up to open up inside of Windows Notepad, so if I just double click on this, it opens up in Windows Notepad. Now if it doesn't do that for you, here's what you do. Right click on that, and then come down to open with right here, and then in here, if it's opening up with something else, that's fine, but what you want to do is click on more apps, and scroll down here and look for the app you want to open that with. WordPad would also work out okay, but I just like using Notepad. That's just great for this. Choose OK, and there you go. Okay, so in here, we have a description up here and a name. There's the description. Notice that it says example vanilla resource pack. That's fine. I'm going to change this one to My Sounds. And let's just change this here. I'll change from vanilla to sounds. There we go. And down here on the description, we can change that as well. I'm just going to copy this description right here. Right click, copy, come down here and select that. Right click, paste. Make sure you keep those quotation marks in there, and that's fine. Now there are two numbers in here, UUID up here and UUID right down here. Now there's one. There's the other one right there. We need to change both of those. And that's why we have this thing over here, the online UUID generator. Click refresh first. I always do that just out of habit. Click on copy, and it copies this code for you. Let's now go back to our text file. Here it is. And then select this whole code right there. Right click and paste. Now you need two different codes. So go back here to this. Click on refresh again. Make sure it changes. There it is. Copy. Back to our manifest, and then change the bottom one again. Select, right click, and paste. Make sure that you still have those quotation marks in there, very important, and then save. Okay, that's all there is to the manifest.json file. That is fixed, and we're done with all this stuff as well. Okay, now all we have left to do is just to take care of our new sounds. You see the sounds have a folder right over here. I'm going to change this back to list view so you can see it a bit better. There's our list view, and there's the sounds folder right there. We don't need anything else in here. We only need just that sounds folder. We need these files right down here, but these folders can go away. So everything from here down to here, I'll just delete that, right click and delete. Get that out of there. And then the texts down to UI, I don't need any of this stuff. Right click and let's get rid of that as well. There we go. Now inside of the sounds folder are all of the sounds for the game. And there's a whole bunch of them in here. You actually don't have to have all of these. All you need to have is just the ones that you're changing. Here's ambient and weather. There's some weather sounds. There's your rain and your thunder. Now we're working with the barrel, and that's going to be one of our blocks right here. Open this up, and there's that barrel. So I actually don't need to have anything else except for the block sounds. I'm not changing anything else. This just makes the resource pack smaller. The more you get rid of things you don't need, the smaller your pack can be. So I recommend getting rid of everything that you're not going to be actually using and only leaving here the things that you do use. So I'll get rid of the ambient and the armor, right click, and let's just delete those. And then I'll click on bottle and scroll down and VR down there. Get rid of all of that stuff. Just hit the delete key. I'll do that on the keyboard. Get rid of all those files. That just kind of cleans things up in here. And there's still a lot of stuff inside of that block folder that I don't need. So we can also delete those as well. Go in here to the block. A lot of stuff. I'll leave this on though because I may want to change some of these other block sounds in the future. So I'll just go ahead and leave these sounds in here and just deal with the block. Now inside a barrel, you'll find three files. And these are the close and then two open sounds. Notice they have an extension of FSB. This is a special sound file that's used in a lot of video games. You cannot edit this file. You can't save to this file format. Doesn't matter. We don't need those two. We'll be replacing these. Now the important thing here though is the name. Open one and open two. Okay, we have our location. Let's now back up. And there's our sounds folder right here. There's the AUG file. I'm going to copy this file, right click, and copy. Let's go back into our resource pack, back into that sounds folder, back into block, back into the barrel, and I'll right click and paste that sound right in here. Okay, there we go. Now I need to have two copies of this, and they need to be named open one and open two because we're replacing those two files. You can replace the FSB file with an OGG file and it'll work out just fine. Let me just rename this first one up here. I'll call this one open one. There it is. Now click on that, right click, and we'll copy that, and then right click and paste. That gives me a copy. I'll just rename this one so that it's open too. And we now have our two OGG files in here that match those two FSB files. At this point, you can remove the FSB files. I'm going to be keeping these though, just in case. I'm going to make a new file in here, right click, and let's do new and folder. And I'll just take those two FSB files and put those into that new folder. Since they're in here, the game is going to ignore those and it will use these in place. So now we have our metal clang file converted to the proper OGG format and also copied in here as the right sound name. And we're all set with the basic resource pack. Now again, inside of the sounds, you can come in here and you can remove anything which you're not using. It will just make your resource pack smaller, which can make it load faster and more successfully. I'll just leave all this stuff in though. Get back to our sounds folder. So this was the original resource pack we downloaded and it's been optimized. Let's go back inside there. We need all of this stuff saved into a new zip file. So I'll just select all of that. There we go. Right click, and I use 7-zip for this. You can use any zip program you want to compile this together, but it has to save it to the .zip format. So if you're using something else aside from 7-zip, make sure to double check that it's saving to the zip format and not some other format. Okay, so I'll add to archive. I like using 7-zip because it works just fine, and again, it's free. You can do a search for 7-zip on Google and you'll find it. In here, make sure that you're set to the zip format. There it is, and I'm just going to change the name up here. I'll leave the .zip up there. I'll just change this name to My Sounds. There we go. Leave everything else as is. Choose OK. This also zips faster if you have fewer stuff in your sounds folder. The less stuff in there, the less stuff it has to be zipped up. Okay, and that then makes it into a zip file right here. If you're not seeing .zip, go up here to the View menu and make sure over here where it says File Name Extensions, make sure that is checked so that you then see that extension. Right click and click Rename right down here and click outside and just backspace over zip and then name this one mcpack. That stands for Minecraft Pack. You get this warning dialog box right here. Choose Yes. And you should see the icon change here to the Minecraft icon. Okay, that's it for the Minecraft resource pack. That's all been done. We now need to install this into Minecraft. Make sure that Minecraft is not running. So if it's up, close it down, close out of Minecraft, and then double click on your new sound resource pack. So I'll just double click on this. This is going to launch Minecraft. And it's going to then install that new resource pack inside of Minecraft for us. It does the whole thing automatically for us. That's the whole bit about renaming that, the MC pack. That lets Minecraft know that we want to reinstall it. There's the import happening right now. Import started. It'll go real fast on this. And there we go. Successfully imported Sounds resource pack. And that's done. Okay, now that that's been installed, we have to activate that in two places to make that work. We first need to activate it for the whole game. And that's right here where it says settings. Go in here. And then in settings, let's scroll down to global resources right here. And you should see it under My Packs. There it is. There's the My Sounds resource pack. Click on that. Click on activate. And then double check up here where it says active. Double check that that is showing. And there it is. Okay, that's all set. Now, let's back out of this. And then we're going to go over into the game itself. Click on play. Let the game start. Now at this page, you either have just one world or whatever it is you're working on. This is only going to be working on your own worlds in here. So choose the world you want to work on and click on that pencil icon over here on the right hand side. And we'll need to activate it for this particular world as well. You activate these things separately for your different worlds. Okay, so I'll scroll down here. Again, there's a resource packs and let's double check active. Notice that it's not showing in here. Come down to My Packs right here. There's the resource pack. Click on that. Click activate. It then loads that into the active set. And there we go. There's My Sounds resource pack right there. You can click on here, but also go ahead and click the edit. It'll resave that resource pack. And we can now play this game and double check, make sure our sound is in there. So I'll click on that. It's loading in those resource packs right there. And we now should have that nice clang sound on that barrel. Now we only did the open sound, so the close will still be the regular kind of woody sound, but the opening sound will be that nice clang sound. And we'll take a look at that as soon as this game loads up here. Okay, there we are. Let me just change my point of view here and let's make sure that we have our new sound on that barrel. Here we go, and let's try it. So there we go. That's how you can change sounds inside of Minecraft Bedrock. Now if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button. Don't forget to click on share and subscribe as well. And for a bunch more Minecraft stuff, take a look at my channel. All right, and I'll see you next time.